Panchayat Minister Mauvin Godinho on Wednesday informed media persons that there was a substantial drop in charter flights this season, but the rise in domestic tourists made up for it by covering losses. He was speaking at the Dabolim airport where he inaugurated two new entry gates that will reduce waiting time for passengers and avoid queues outside. The washroom in the immigration area has also been renovated.
Today's function is, it is the endeavor of the Airport Authority of India, led by its director, to be the best among all the airports. If there is a saying, you have to be not only be good, better, best. So their endeavor is to be the best in all terms. As you have seen, two additional washrooms have been commissioned today. And if you look at those washrooms, both the interiors, exteriors, with the type of amenities that they have created, shows that it is of true international class. And that is what the Dabolim Airport is all about. We are not lacking behind in any form. Like, for example, you have a babysitting arrangement when the mother moves to the ladies' toilet. For single fathers as well, similar facility is there. And if you look at the interior, you don't feel you're in a bathroom. Two additional departure gates have been commissioned, and they have done it in the modern way, wherein even air conditioning will not be affected. So what it shows that we are moving in a direction that all that was lacking is being provided in the shortest possible time. Now, instead of just two gates, we are going to have three departure gates, as well as one will be specially reserved for VIPs. So there are going to be in effect four gates. What does this show? Expansion in its true sense. And I think when expansion of this sort takes place, it is in tune with the rising air traffic all over the world. I think even in Goa or at the national level, air traffic growth has not been less than 18 to 20%. So naturally we have to cater. At one time you have seen arguments disappearing whether we need MOPA. There were arguments when we have this airport. You have seen the number of people arriving, passenger traffic increasing at Dabolim itself. So it is a case for both the airports surviving. Dabolim has a truly world-class international airport, which is important. And if you look at the amenities that are being provided, speaks volumes of all the kind that are necessary for such an airport. There has been a temporary decrease in the number of charters, but I must say there has been a proportional increase in the number of domestic tourists arriving in Goa, the people preferring Goa. I think we have gained, though we would have liked to gain with such things happening after the tragedy in Kerala. The tourists who used to go there to God's own country are coming where God dwells. I say Goa is a place where God dwells himself. So we have to keep up good infrastructure. And to keep up good infrastructure, I must compliment the Airport Authority of India, its director Mr. Negi, also Mr. Malik, and all their colleagues who have made it really happen. It is something commendable, because a proper application of mind and hard work gives these results.
I must thank all the stakeholders, including CISF, airlines, customs, immigration, for helping us to do all the modification work that we have shown you today. In fact, the main challenge for our AI team, including the engineers and the others, contractors, was to carry out the work in a functional terminal building. We were working at the same time, we were handling the passengers also. You know the number of passengers that fly through Goa Airport. We renovated the entire washroom. At the same time, we catered for the passengers' requirement also. Even if you see the gates, these were one of the gates was the old gate, which we closed and renovated. At the same time, we were managing the passenger flow also. So for our team, AI team, and the contractors which we engaged, the main challenge was to do this work in the functional terminal building. Today's facilities, three facilities that the Honorable Minister inaugurated. See, the washroom you have already seen, it is one of the best washrooms you must have ever seen in any of the airports, with the facilities that we have provided. In addition to that, we have started two new gates today. As the Honorable Minister said, we are going to have four gates in future, out of which one gate is exclusively for the staff or the elderly people or the other dignitaries like ministers and MLAs, and three gates we'll have for the exclusive passengers. As of now, we are only having two gates. Because of that, when the peak time is there, we have a lot of congestion in the city side. Already we have very less space in the city side of the terminal. So with these three new gates for the passengers are going to be distributed among three gates instead of two. So the passengers have to wait less time in the queue. Correspondingly, we have got number of CSF personnel also to man those gates. So everything will be smooth after, say, once we have the one more gate which is going to be commissioned in 1 month. Correspondingly, we are modifying all the gates, even the arrival gates also we are modifying. Because if you see, as I told you, the gates which are now, straightway they open into the city side, into the terminal building, because of which there were air conditioning losses. So with the new gates, modified gates, the air conditioning loss also will reduce.
Bureau report, Don Bosco Channel.